everybody. Saturday, October 10th. We got the hay head on the chopper last night. So I'm going to put the feeder wagon on here. My brother Paul's up cutting some now. We'll try it out, chop some for the cows, and then we'll start filling the bag right away. So that's what we're up to today. We got a little bit chopped in here just for the cows. For this being a lot of orchard grass, which is a real fine grass, this thing is chopped up pretty nice. We just got a little ways because the had to change a guard on the hay bind and adjust the hay head height on the chopper a little bit. So I'm gonna bring this out for the cows now. My brother Paul's gonna keep cutting here, and then we'll start chopping. It's a nice day out, just beautiful. It was hot yesterday, I think it got over 80. That was a little too warm for my liking, but we'll take it. Better than snow. Everybody, about 8:30 in the morning, October 11th. We are going to fire up and chop a load of hay for the cows this morning, and then I want to get that bag finished off today. My brother's coming over. We got about probably half, maybe a little more of this field done yesterday. I got to make quite a few rounds to get a load. It's places in the middle, it's a little thinner. It's pretty nice hay, but places it's heavy, places it's thinner. And I've got one more field up in the back, so either put both fields in the bag and we'll call it good, or if the bag gets full first, whichever comes first, then we'll be done with the bagger, because I need to get that back to Johnny, because he's got that little bit of my grandpa's corn left to do yet, and that's getting dry, and he's also got some hay to do, so I don't want to hold up that bagger from him any longer than I need it, because he's been nice enough to let me use it, and like I said, with having the extra feed, I've had it longer than I anticipated, so I want to get that back to him. So we're going to fire up, chop for the cows, and then I've just been cutting. You probably noticed I've been chopping pretty much right behind the hay bind. Normally, like if you're in this, you know, spring, summer doing haylage, you would cut it, leave it dry a little bit, you know, I think maybe 50% moisture, something like that, and then chop it. This stuff is pretty dry on its own right now, just because it's, you know, it has froze, the plant is shutting down, and we've had some pretty good drying weather, so, and there is some, you know, stuff in here. This plant, like I said, has started shutting down, a lot of this grass, so it's a nice moisture now. It's bagging really well. It's not just turning into mush in the bagger, so, and I don't want to have more cut down than I, you know, I don't know how many loads exactly it's going to take, so I don't want to have extra cut down than I need to fill the bag, because especially tonight they're talking, I think there's supposed to be like an inch of rain coming through, so I don't want to cut everything down and, you know, have 3-4 loads left laying there that gets wrecked. I can bale it later and wrap it or whatever. So but anyway, so that's why I'm chopping right behind the haybine. If it was earlier in the year, especially in the spring when there's a lot of moisture in the hay, you would leave it sit and dry. But now it's pretty much ready to go when it's cut. So anyway, that's what I'm doing now. I'm just gonna start this tractor, let it warm up. I gotta put some fuel in it, and we'll start chopping. Beautiful morning out this morning. Nice sunrise. It's probably my favorite time of the year. Weather like this. Sometimes you can get them falls that are nasty and wet and cold, but this one's been beautiful. Can't complain at all. Really blessed with this weather to get these crops in, and with the crops we've had, just really blessed.
Okay, ready? You didn't get it in your mouth, did ya? Hey, where you going? This is the Kettle River, and it's just down from our field, right up there. nice, huh?
Started over there with his again and get that corn that my grandpa's finished off.